Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we are reviewing a pen that, as I said yesterday, it is not, I don't believe it is a rare pen, but it is quite unusual to see. And this pen is the Dagong 56. This pen was bought from eBay and it is a Chinese pen. And the most interesting thing about it is that it is a clone of the Pilot Cutlass fountain pen, which is interesting because there aren't many around. There are a few retractable nib fountain pens, very few. I think one from Visconti, another from Lamy, maybe some more that I'm forgetting now, but this is really a replica of the Pilot. So let's take a look at the pen. The pen came inside this plastic box. You can see it is an old box, but it's okay. And the is like this. It is an aluminum pen with these plastic black grip, and there is not much more about it. So let's see the details about the pen. First, as I said, this is aluminum. It has a clip which is really stiff and hard to operate. Then you have this black knurled section to hold the pen. This is not rubbery or anything like that, it's just a black plastic. I think this is made to help people grip the pen. When you hold the Pilot, you tend to hold it closer to the nib, but I think when they made this pen, they wanted people to hold the pen a little bit above the clip. So it is easier not to have the clip beneath your between your fingers, but I'm not really sure about it. I prefer to hold the pen a little bit downer. So that's it. It has the same slanted cut here. The nib is inside this opening. When you press the button, there's a door, trap door that opens and the nib comes out exactly as you can see on the Pilot Cutlass. The barrel has the engraving of a dragon, I think you can see, which is interesting. And then it has a black end to the button. And there is not much more about it. We'll see the inside. I will just compare it to some other Pilot Cutlass. These are genuine. This is the modern one, so you can see even the clip has this little groove to put your fingers and hold the pen. And you can see it is quite different because this ring where you twist the pen, it is on the other half of the pen. But we have here a more vintage Pilot Cutlass, and as you can see, it is much more similar to the Dagong. The rings here where you open the pen, they are at the same place. They have roughly the same width. They have this metal section that is at the same place also, but the clip on this pen is much higher. And I think Pilot wanted you to hold here and avoid the clip. And this one has a shorter clip but a longer section, and the clip moves upwards to hold the pen back. In the modern ones, they want you to hold the pen near the nib in this groove. of the clip. So different ways to hold the pen, and the biggest difference between these two is this, the way you should hold the pen. There's also these little, here it is metal, here it is black plastic, but these pens are much more similar. There are more similarities between the Dagong and these vintage Pilot Cutlass than between the two Pilot Cutlasses. So let's see more inside. There's nothing more to see. Besides that, we can unscrew the barrel, and here you have the pen. What I've been noticing in this fountain pen, I have it for a very short time, is that the nib always gets covered up with ink. Let me just clean it a little bit. When it is inside the pen, it gets covered with ink, and that makes me fear that some ink may be leaking inside the pen, and then it may corrode the springs and stuff that make the pen work. So I hope not, but I don't think I'll keep this pen inked, and I don't think I will use it a lot. I will keep it on my collection just like it. But it is a way to it's here to show on the blog, and then it will go to the collection. We have a steel nib, gold color steel nib, very similar to Pilot nibs, very very similar. It has this ring with this raised part to make sure you put the nib in the right position, not like this. And unlike the Pilot Cutlass, this one doesn't have converter or cartridge. This one has a built-in aerometric system. So I think the other one, the Pilots, are easier to use. And here, maybe it is impossible to see, you have the symbol of Dagong, and then after it's 56. So we can know which is the name of the model. We'll put the pen back in the nib section and screw the barrel in place. And here it is. And now let's just see how this pen writes. And here we are again. Let's see how the pen performs. So, just one little consideration. The nib and how you see the nib. When you activate the nib on this pen, it protrudes a lot less than the Pilot nibs. And here we have the modern one that protrudes even more. So they are different in this particular thing. So let's see. This is uncapped now. Maybe it won't write right away, but let's see. The paper is the usual Rhodia dot pad. The ink is Montegrappa brown, and the pen is the Dagong 56. So, what can we say about this? The pen is as comfortable or uncomfortable to hold as the Pilot Cutlass, so there's no specific feature about it. What we have to say is this nib is really, really fine. It has no marking, but it is a really fine nib. I think this is an extra fine or even finer. So it has a very, very thin line. And so it is not the most smooth nib you can find. It puts down a good amount of ink, but it's not very wet. Also, the ink I have inside the pen is not very wet also. The ink flow is good when you write slowly, but if you try to write more quickly, there are not exactly skips, but you can see there is less ink going to the tip of the nib. But the pen writes, and it is quite fine. You can try to reverse writing, and this is something very strange, because in this pen, and I think you can hear, this is the normal writing. It's not scratchy, but you can hear. And now reverse writing. This pen is smoother in the underside than the other way around. It's strange, but happens. About line variation, there is any. This is a very stiff nib, just like the Pilot nibs. This pen usually is quite expensive on eBay, around 100 euros or something like that. This was cheaper, but sometimes you get these cheaper, but I think they are quite expensive, because you see there is not the same quality. Sometimes when you put the nib unit inside the pen, you can feel that it is not straight into through the spring, and it gets stuck. You can see the clip is not straight, and it moves from one way to another, so it's not a fine thing. This plastic grip sound looks like cheap. So this pen is an interesting collectible item, because it is really effective replica of the Pilot Cutlass. It has this nice Chinese design, but it's more like that, something that you want to keep because it's fun, but not because it is a great writing instrument. Although it writes, although it performs, but the ink over the nib makes me fear that it may leak inside the pen. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please hit the thumbs up button and the subscribe button also, to be sure you get informed of every video we upload. And I'll try to keep uploading videos about some more unusual pens that I have in my collection. So thank you so much for your time, and come back soon. Bye.